Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common problems with the Toyota 3UR-FE engine. The Toyota 3UR-FE engine was offered from 2007 until 2021 in the Toyota Tundra, Sequoia, Land Cruiser 200 series, as well as the Lexus LX570. The 3UR is a 5.7-liter V8 engine featuring dual VVTi and delivers 381 horsepower and 401 pound-feet of torque. Ultimately, the Toyota 3UR-FE offers a great overall balance of reliability, longevity, and performance. However, no engine is perfect, and that applies here as well, as the 3UR-FE also suffers from its fair share of common issues. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common problems with the Toyota 5.7 liter V8. Number one on the list, we have cam tower oil leaks. When it comes to cam tower oil leaks, this is a problem that can likely be classified as a truly common issue and one that affects a rather large percentage of these Toyota 5.7 liter V8s. So the cam towers on the 5.7 liter 3UR engine lie underneath the valve covers, and instead of using gaskets, Toyota actually opted to use an RTV sealant. And what happens is over time, that sealant wears down, becomes less effective, and no longer properly seals the cam towers to the valve cover, and ultimately results in the cam tower oil leak. When these leaks first start, they're typically on the smaller side and typically begin at the rear side of the cam tower and valve covers, which ultimately leads to the oil leaking off and dripping onto the extremely hot exhaust manifolds. So a lot of the times when you first run into this oil leak, you might not even notice any oil spots or stains on the ground. Instead, that oil drips onto the manifolds and burns off quickly, and that will result in light smoke coming from the engine bay, as well as burning oil smells. And as that leak progresses, you can continue getting those symptoms, as well as it finally making its way onto the ground as the leak gets bigger and bigger. So unfortunately, when it comes to cam tower oil leaks, it is a relatively labor-intensive and expensive repair. A lot of the times this can work out into the ballpark of $1,200 to $1,500 plus dollars just to repair and fix these cam tower oil leaks. Now really almost all of that cost boils down to labor. So if you are able to DIY this, which it isn't an overly complicated job, but certainly does require some experience and knowledge, if you're able to do that, it's certainly a lot more affordable to fix these cam tower oil leaks and is often only a couple hundred dollars in parts and maybe a couple other things you want to replace while you're in there. Moving on to our second most common problem, we have water pump failure. Now, this is a minor issue in the grand scheme. Water pumps are often designed with weep holes to allow coolant to leak out of, which allows the water pump to actually continue working properly and circulating coolant normally throughout the cooling system. And that's exactly what happens with the 3UR-FE water pump. When it fails, it's often just a coolant leak from the weep hole on the water pump, which fortunately isn't an extremely urgent repair. Again, the water pump should continue functioning properly, so this isn't something that's going to leave you stranded on the side of the road with a severely overheating engine. Now, it is possible to run into a complete water pump failure, but again, most oftentimes with the 3UR-FE, when we talk about water pump failure, a lot of the times it's just that coolant leak coming from the weep hole of the pump and something that isn't an urgent repair or something that's going to leave you stranded on the side of the road. Now, it's pretty common for these pumps to show problems and leaks anywhere in the ballpark of about 60 to 120,000 miles. However, some of these water pumps do also hold up to 150,000 plus miles without any issues. So this isn't a guaranteed problem or something that's extremely common or soon on in the engine's life, but definitely something to be on the lookout for and consider, especially as you start pushing closer and closer to that 100,000 plus mile range. Last but not least, our third common problem is high oil consumption. This might not even be something that's entirely fair to discuss in this video or consider a truly common problem. And the reason for that is the high oil consumption hasn't shown to cause any longevity, reliability concerns, or issues with the engine. However, they are known to consume an excessive amount of oil, especially as the 3UR continues aging. This could simply boil down to piston ring clearances and just a little extra oil seeping into essentially the cylinders and burning off compared to some other engines that may have tighter clearances and might not burn as much oil. So again, a lot of the times this isn't a serious issue or cause for concern. However, with some of these older engines, especially as they are getting higher in mileage, high oil consumption could be a symptom of another underlying issue like internal problems or just wear and tear on the engine. But again, in most cases, this isn't something that's serious or really going to affect the longevity or reliability of the Toyota 5.7 liter V8. So really the only important thing here is if you're noticing high oil consumption, if you can confirm it isn't coming from some other underlying issue like an oil leak or anything of that nature, a lot of the times the most important factor is really just ensuring that you're keeping the engine topped up on oil, since running it low on oil for extended periods of time can certainly cause additional wear and tear and stress on the engine. Change the oil on time, and really this should be a non-issue. Anyway, that really wraps up the three most common problems with the Toyota 3UR-FE engine. So in summary of the common problems and overall reliability of this engine, we talked about the cam tower oil leaks, which are a fairly common problem and something that can be an expensive repair. So that's one thing that does hold this engine back a little bit from a reliability standpoint. But outside of that issue, I discussed the water pump failure, which is often just coolant leaking from the weep hole, something that you should still replace and get fixed sooner than later, but it's not really a major issue and certainly not something that's serious in the grand scheme and is a relatively inexpensive and simple fix. And then lastly, there's the high oil consumption, which really isn't known to cause any serious reliability or longevity concerns. So outside of those couple little issues there, the 3UR is really a great engine. Maintain it well, change your oil on time, make sure your oil levels are topped up, use quality oils, fix problems in a timely manner if and when they do occur. All basic maintenance stuff that should be done on any engine or any vehicle. Do all of that and the Toyota 3UR-FE can be a great engine that lives a very reliable life to 200 or even 250,000 plus miles. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.